Yeah, we're gonna pick this interview up, man. Y'all tune in, man. It's gonna come in.
Try that one of these days with me, man. If I would choose anybody to go out there to the golf course and just play naturally, it would be you, Ruben. You got natural athletic, man. I know you can play that tennis, basketball, pretty much everything, man. Ping pong, all of the sports, man. You always were competitive in it. So maybe we have to get out there one of these days and range up like that. Hey, man, that's all right. I think you can pick it up, man, if you go out there and try it. I really do. Yeah, but I'm on here, man, this morning early. I'm feeling good, man. I'm in my positive vibe, man. Can't nothing negative come to me right now. It's going to get the highs, man. A real stiffer, you know what I mean? Get back. And usually the negative ones, they don't even run your way because they can't deal with that energy you got. But I'm burning up some live this morning, man, because it's free. You know what I mean? They don't charge you for this live. I'm going to get on here and I'm going to give it to you just like it is. Everything's raw and uncut, man. Ain't no filters, nothing like that, man. Ain't no faking and shaking. This is me, raw and uncut. Yeah, man, we live, man. Early in the morning, 7:16, man. You can see the sun trying to peak around the horizon, man. It's still a little dark out there on that range. So it's a little early if you're trying to get out there, man. I got everything that I need, man. From the heart, bro. From the heart, man. You know how I do it, man. Straight from the heart, man. It's all real. Raw and uncut, man. We need to catch up, man. Next time, I was down in Killeen. It's been a couple of months ago, man. I was down there. I didn't mess with you because, man, I know you probably was at work or busy. I was down there to check on my pop's grave, man. You know, it's all right down there because they keep it good, nice, and manicured and everything. I just went down there, and I spent a little time just creeping around. Went to a couple of spots, but I didn't bother nobody, man, because I was on a mission, and I didn't give nobody no heads up. I don't like to pop up on nobody just like that, man, just because I'm on my own schedule. But, man, it's feeling good, man. I want to motivate somebody, man, because we've been having too much negative energy and too much negative conversation about 2020, man. We're going to dog 2020 just because of some things that's going on in 2020 with the virus and everything. Yeah, that's here. It's here, so we got to deal with it. We can't keep on crying and complaining and crying over spilled milk. You know, we got to do something about it, man. So what I say is, you know, just with the mindset that I have, man, you got to call an audible on the line, man. Sometimes you can't run the play that you've been running. Just because we ran a certain play from 1996 cleaned up to 2019 don't mean we got to keep on running that same play, man. It's 2020, man. It's time to adjust. It's time to run an audible, man. Change up a little bit. Don't look at it as a negative thing. Just look at it as you having an opportunity to do something that you haven't done before, man. You know, we've been spending a little more time with our loved ones, our close ones. If you look at it, you know, we haven't been just jumping on these planes and getting that cabin with all that old refurbished air they bring it through there. We found different things to do, you know, things that said couldn't be done is being done. People are working from home. Why do they got to go back and work in the building? They've been working from home this time. You're getting it done now, you know what I mean? Save on that rent that you're paying on that building. So we just got to figure out some things, man. Start calling some audibles. Keeping ourselves safe. Wear your mask, man. If you got to wear a mask, wear your mask.
Right on.
Wear your sanitizer, you know. I think it's changed some people, man. Some people who wasn't believing, they starting to believe, man, because this whole thing started hitting close to home, man. We don't know how it works. It is very tricky, man. It gets some and won't get the others, man. So just do the best you can, man. Stay on top of your main swing. Mm-hmm. You know, get your mind right. Serve a cause greater than yourself sometimes. You know, you got to think about other people sometimes, man, other than yourself. You know, I'm just thankful, man. I'm a very blessed person in certain ways, man. So I believe that I'm a blessing. And God uses you as a blessing sometimes to bless other people, man. And I appreciate that, man. If that's the case, man, God, use me up. Keep using me. And help me put other people in position, man, to do whatever it is they can do to help somebody, man. There's so many people out here, man, that you never will realize it on the real. They really selfish. And it shows because their growth is stunning. You know, you always think you're winning, but you always find yourself trying to win again. Or you always find yourself trying to chase a bag, man. See, God will put you in a position sometimes where you don't have to chase no bag. You see, the bag will come to you, man. God will bring you royalties. You know what I mean? You know, ever heard of what a royalty check is? See, sometimes God will put you in a position to where you get royalties. You know, and it doesn't have to be monetarily, man. It could be so many different things, man. It could be help. He give you a royalty on health, man. I'm going to give you help for this so long. It could be food, man. He give you nourishment for so much, man, you know. So you got to be righteous in your walk, man. When you're righteous in your walk, that's like right now, man, what you get, man, it's unmolested right now, man. This is me in the flesh, man. I know when to be positive. I like to have fun, man. I can be a very fun person. I can be a clown, man. I clown the clown sometimes. Somebody who's supposed to be the funniest person, I'm going to go get him. You know what I mean? That's the many facets of me, man. But right now, man, this is it. Wicked and wrong. I know when to sit back and let somebody else have the 15 minutes of fame. It's theirs. Let them have it. I ain't going to try to take it. You know what I mean? Let them have what they're supposed to have, man. But when I'm working, when I'm doing my work, you better get back, you know, because I'm going to let you know it and let you have it, man. I know what dedication is, man. I know what grinding is. I know what sacrifice is. Sometimes you do things that you don't want to do. I don't want to get up early every morning and get out there and start grinding like that sometimes. But I do anyway. That's part of the sacrifice. That's part of the grind. That's part of the hustle. That's part of the part that the things that you don't want to do, the intangibles, but you need, you got to get up and do it when you don't want to do it, you know. So I get up and do things that I don't want to do at times, man. And that right there keeps me going. I'm just giving you my blueprint on what it is I do, you know. Maybe it'll help somebody. You know, you're going to talk about some things sometimes. You're going to do some things. You're going to do some great things. And even when you do those great things, there's going to be some people that don't like you doing great things. You know what I mean? You're going to do some terrible things. There's going to be people out there that are going to glorify you for those terrible things because they really want to see you fall out. Man, it's human nature. It's what it is, man. And see, I try to talk about the hard things sometimes without being so negative, you know, just as a sense of awareness, man, to give people awareness, because the things that we think are not, they actually are, because we are human. So people you think that are in your corner rooting for you, clapping you on, you can see they be right there. Hey, that's my boy right there. They really don't care about you like that. They really waiting for you to fall off. They want to see your demise. They want to see your fall. So, and that's human nature. I'm just telling you. Don't fall for the okey-doke. Don't fall for the old banana in the tailpipe. You know? Hey, they can be riding with you every day. And I'm just telling you what God love and the devil hate, man, that's the truth. And sometimes we got to talk about the hard things, man. Sometimes we got to talk about hey, it's like I say, don't mix salt in your sugar. It'll never taste the same ever, man, again.
Ever.
Never. You're not going to be able to distinguish those grains. You know what I'm saying? Salt looks just like sugar. And when you mix that salt in your sugar, it's changed forever. So you just got to learn how to navigate through what you did. A lot of time, man, you don't need friends to, you know, justify what it is that you're doing. Just go do, long as you're doing it in a righteous manner.
Man.
Long as you're being righteous in whatever it is that you're trying to do, be righteous with it. Man, you ain't got to worry about what nobody think. You know what I mean? Toughen your skin up. You know? Toughen your skin up.
Get on top of your man.
Don't be worrying about what people think and what people saying. You know, everybody not going to like you. You know what I'm saying? everybody doesn't like God. So if he don't have the blueprint to making everybody like you, don't think that you're going to be able to find it. You know what I mean? Don't think you're going to be able to find the cure for it. You know what I mean?
Check.
Some people are going to hate you because these people love you. Man, and some people are going to love you because they hate you. So it's a mix. You know, so my thing is just do you. Be natural. You know, that's like myself, man. I don't come on here with no script. I don't have no script. I didn't write nothing, man. This is me raw and uncut in the flesh, man. Giving it to you how it's supposed to be given. Ain't no faking and shaking. You know, I don't have no script. I get on here and I give you what I got mentally, straight off the head. Some people might say, oh, he tripping or he crazy. Or, nah, this is me. You know what I mean? I want people to know that I'm really no different from you. You know, we all the same pretty much. You know what I mean? We all bleed that red stuff, man. Yeah. So this is me off the rip, man. I can get on here and be real proper the whole time. And I would be way off script. You know what I mean? I can get on here and proper and play like I'm somebody else. Or I can get on here and be someone I know that I'm not. You know, I can do that. I'm talking about the entire time from start to finish. I can change up everything. Change up my tone. I can change up my behavior. The way I talk to you. How I carry myself. I can do all that. But man, what I'm going to change for what? I'm going to get you who I am. You know what I'm saying? Pure, natural, unmolested, unadulterated, man. Yeah.
The funk, baby.
See? Be yourself. Amen. And sometimes you have to do some things without your so-called friends, man. You got to leave them behind, man. You can knock on their door. You can call them. You can text them. But if they don't want to be there, they're not going to go. They're not going to go. They're going to find every reason it is. So you can't wait for nobody. You can't hold your hand out and hope that they make it to the... You can't do that. You just got to keep doing you. You got to keep doing the right thing. You got to keep on setting the bar up higher. You got to do that. So when you do that, when you set the bar up, when you keep going, eventually they may want to come. But my thing is, then you can lend a hand up. You know, there's nothing wrong with lending a hand up. You know, the hands that hand out are the ones that are the things that really mess people up. When you just handing them this, handing them that, handing them this, handing them that, those are the things that really mess people up because they don't really appreciate it. Now, hand up, you know, say you'll give them a lift up, but they got to show you something. Show you that they want to be there. Show them that what you're handing out really means something and they can be self-sufficient once they get it, you know. Because any and everything can wear out its welcome. But anyway, man, I'm just on this vibe, man, chit-chatting before it's time to get here and hit these balls, man, long and straight. Because the live is free. And being that the live is free, man, I'm using it, you know. This morning, we're going to get down with the get down. I done dreamed about playing golf all night long. So I got up this morning, I had to do something, man. I started making my moves early this morning. I went and I cleaned off my golf club, man. I cleaned off my ball. We did all that, man. I've done that about 3 or 4 times, man. Because after you sleep and dream about it for so long, it's time to get up. It's time to get up. How can I start playing golf before my tee time? So prepping yourself. Make sure you're comfortable when you get there. I'm going to be comfortable. When I get down there, I'm not going to be thinking about anything but get on top of my game, man. Man, it's been beautiful, man. This is all part of my birthday. You know, my wife knows she sent me out. Let me get out of here. She know what I love to do. And I've been thankful that she's supportive of things that I like to do, too. You know what I mean? Because I'm going to support her in every aspect, man, that it takes to keep her happy and successful in the things she's doing and on top of her grind. And I appreciate that she knows that this is something I love, man. I put a lot of energy in it, a lot of learning, put finances in it, man. But something that you love, man, you'll be good at it. I don't have to play every day. I would love to play every day,
man.
But then I know I have to pull away from it too. So to focus on other things. And it's just a beautiful morning this morning, man. This is a blessing, especially for me, man. I look at life totally different right now. Me and my bro, Bill, we talked about accountability, man, in his interview. And that right there was the part that stuck to me the most, man, accountability. You know, I have to be more accountable too, you know. I try to always be accountable for things, man, but I got to be more accountable. I got to be more vocal, you know. Coming into this point in my life, man, you know, I'm not just an OG. I'm a triple OG, man. That means a lot, you know. So when you're triple OG, you have accountability, you know. And there's going to be some other OGs that's going to test you. And when that happens right there, you got to be accountable to making them accountable, man. I'm going to make them accountable. You know, we're not going to be continuously co-signing some of this bad behavior that's going on out here and not addressing it, man. Yeah. Some things can be done, and it needs to be addressed in-house. But then there's some things, when these behaviors get bad, man, it's going to have to be addressed to the public, man. And that's just a fact. If they don't like it, then so be it, man. They better do something to make it better. But anyway, man, we're not going to lean on that too much. We're just going to ride out some of this free live, man, we get, man. It's paid for, you know what I mean? It's paid for, man. We're paying taxes and everything out here, so every now and then, if you want to get on the live, man, but just have something to say. You know what I'm saying? Come from the heart. You know, let us know what that mindset really all about, man. See, you're getting my mindset off the rip, raw and uncut. Everything is being freestyle, man. It's what I do. And then we get on here and we talk about it, man, chit-chat. And like my boy Ruben said, man, that's a saying I use, too, quite frequent, man. He said, you can lead a horse to water, but you can't make it drink, you know? And that's a true story statement, man. We can show our friends, man. That's coming from Kirby Rubin, man. He put his input. We can show our friends. But bottom line, it's their decision to change, man. That's a true statement, man. And I want to make sure it got put out there the same way he put it out there. You can lead a horse to water, but you can't make it drink. And we can show our friends, et cetera. But the bottom line is their decision to change. It's their own decision, man. Yeah, I always say that too, man. You can't make nobody nothing, man. You can make some suggestions and stuff, and they can take it if they want it, but you can't make nobody nothing, man. They got to want it, man. You can make somebody do something, man, and confine them to a certain area, make them do this stuff all day under your force, under duress. But and you walk away, man, they start doing what they want to do anyway, man. Next thing you know, they down in central booking somewhere, man. You know, indicting on something, got some kind of sealed indictment or something because they didn't listen to you, man. You know, at least you did put your energy, that positive energy into them and try to help them, man, some type of way, man. But sometimes you got to pull away and let people go and do what they're going to do because it's in their character, man. Sometimes we got to bump our heads before we actually learn anything, man. That's what we want to do, man. We're human. And like I said, everybody's not going to like you. Everybody's not going to love you. Everybody ain't going to show you no love. Everybody ain't going to do it. You can't worry about that, man. And remember, like I told you earlier, Facebook is only that small, man. You know, if you got 1,500 friends on here, that ain't the world. That's just 1,500 people that done hit friend me. Or something like that, man. Some of them probably ain't even your friend. Don't care nothing about you, man. They ain't worrying about you. You know what I mean? But you gotta experience the world, man. I'm thankful to God that I left home at an early age, 18, man. I had a lot of influence from my father, man, and my brother. They never, and they went around the world early age, and I seen their picture on the wall, and I wanted my picture up on the wall like their picture was on the wall, man. So in order for me to do it and have it up there like this, man, I had to make a decision to sign up and give an oath, man, to get up out of here.
Man, I
did
oath.
That, man. It's probably one of the greatest decisions I ever made, man. I don't regret nothing about the decisions I made. You know, I didn't get to go to the college I really wanted to go to. I had scholarships to other schools, but the school I really wanted to go to, I didn't get no offer. Or the letter didn't get to the people. I didn't get the letter that they sent. So, with that being said, my decision changed up, and I ended up going to the service, man. I don't regret nothing
Austin,
about it.
Texas on the big stage, man.
And my wife, she chimed in, man, I just want to put this stuff out here. She said, you have to want it for yourself. And that's a true statement, too. You know, I don't want nobody's comments to come on here to go unheard, but you have to want it for yourself, man. That is, man. We, a lot of times we do want stuff for other people, man. We want it bad for them. We want to see them get it. We want to see them win that trophy. We want to see them get that award. We want to see them whatever it may be, man.
Yeah.
But then they got to want it for themselves. They got to put that extra work in. You know, that's how a lot of people make it big and whatever that they're doing, because they're working when nobody else is working, when everybody don't want to sleep and quit and close their book just because they got a passing grade. Oh, I don't know, I'm at least making 70 or 75. I don't know that. But then, you know what I'm saying? Lil Popcorn, he's still up working late night in the albums, doing all his figures. Shoot, Lil Popcorn got 100.
He deserved
it. Oh, yeah. He deserved more. That's he right. worked harder.
I'm listening,
he put some extra work in it.
I'm listening.
More time, man. He put more time in, so he's very deserving of whatever it is he got coming to him, man. Yeah, but like I said, man, we're here this morning, man. We just riding at this live. Riding this live out because it's free. It's paid for. And you getting me raw in the cut. This is just me. Man, this is Jim in the flesh. Jim going to give it to you. So Jim's in the hood. I'm going to be coming out, man, every now and then. I'm going to interview somebody on the spot, man. I don't care who it is. And they're gems, man. We're going to get something positive out of people, man.
That's right.
When we start introducing a little bit more about gems in the hood. So I just want to see, let them know that us common people, us normal people, us regular, everyday people, man, out here in the world, we are gems, man. And the world is our hood. Ain't nowhere in the world that we can't go. A lot of times we confine ourselves. So when we confine ourselves, we restrict ourselves from being better. We restrict ourselves from growing. See, our minds, we put our minds in a penitentiary. We put our minds in a penal code, you know what I mean?
Right.
And keep our minds confined, and we don't reach out. And a lot of times, man, somebody else to say something, and instead of us doing our research, or instead of us using our own mind, or instead of us
we go off what they say.
Using our own intellect, man, what will happen is we'll just jump on the bandwagon. Oh, what he said sounds good. Oh, it sounds good, but it really don't mean, you know, not for me. So use your own mind, man. You know, don't just go with the flow. Don't just run the way the wind blows. You know what I mean? Go the way the wind blow. Sometimes you got to stay planted. That's why you got to build your foundation, man. That's why you have to appreciate your village, man. You have uncles and aunties and nieces and nephews, cousins. Man, build that relationship there. You know, a lot of times we go around talking about our own people to other people that we don't even know. Go talking about your cousins, talk about your friends, and I mean your family members and stuff to complete strangers. So what do you think they're thinking about you? If you go around here and talk about your uncle, your auntie, your mama, your daddy, your sister, your brother, your cousin, about, you talk about them to a complete stranger, what do you think them people think about you?
Well, tell it like you're supposed to be
told. You ain't loyal. You talk about them. Man, that is what it is. So you got to watch people, man. And some people are smart enough to know when you full of it.
There you go.
Know what I mean? Yeah.
I ain't like just I listening. Said, I'm adhering.
That's a true statement too, Rube. You can't underestimate a C-student. Yeah. Man, you can get a lot of learning from different areas, man. Somebody who was a straight A student will get out here in this old mean, cruel world and fail all day long. But somebody that made F's, D's, C's all through school, they'll get out here in this mean, cruel world, they'll excel, man. So, yeah, we can't underestimate nobody, man. That's why I don't, man. I don't underestimate nobody, man. I love everybody, man. People that have been addicted, man. People that are in great places, millionaires, broken, problems. You know, I admire everybody, man, some type of way, because you never know who is walking on this earth that could be something that's from another place, man. You never know.
Tell it like it's supposed to be told. It's like it froze up on us, man. But we're going to ride it out, man. You never know, man, who's who. So I'm going to pick it up from here. You never know who's who. You never know who's somebody in disguise, man, that could be the person to help you, uplift you, and catapult you to the next episode in your life, you know. So, man, watch how you treat people, man. Watch how you do people. See, I've been sitting back here listening to some of the words that were coming out this morning, man. It was live, man. It was like a spirit that was over me, man, just saying talk. To give it out there, man. Uplift somebody, man. Because 2020 has been painted to us as a frightening time in our life, man. But it ain't that frightening. Sometimes you just have to step up to the line and call an audible, man. I'm going to say it again. And when you call that audible, all you're doing is changing up the way you've been doing business on a day-to-day basis, man. You have to do it a little bit differently, man. You have to adjust on the spot. Change up those ways, man. And make the best of what's out in front of you. Sometimes you might have to wear a mask, man. Sometimes you may have to put on sanitizer and stuff, man. You come home, take those clothes off and put them in the air and wash them clothes, man. And don't spread stuff around your house, man. It's causing us to clean up. We need to clean up some, man. That's what it is. We're sanitizing our lives, man. That's what Corona got us doing. We're sanitizing our lives a little bit. Sometimes we may have to take a step back. Sometimes we may have to slow down. See, the world done sped up so fast, man. Everything is www.this and www.that. Slow it down some, man. We want everything right now. You go online and order something online. You want it 10 minutes from now, man. Wait for it, man. It may take 3 to 5 shipping days. Sometimes it may take up to 7 to 10. You know what I mean? Slow it down some. Wait for it. You wasn't getting it that fast back in 1980. So, man, slow it down. Let's turn back the hands of time a little bit. Slow your roll. You know, enjoy the moment, man. Embrace your people. Love on your people. You know what I mean? Can't no cat from me, like me. I done been to a lot of places, man. A lot of different states and a lot of different nations, international and everything, man. My name is I. John Maynard Jr., if you want to know. And I tell people that I stand for internationally known. Because I get around, man. Been doing it for a while. So, a cat like me can't leave from Texas and go to New York, go to Harlem, or leave here and go to California, go to Compton somewhere, man, Long Beach, and infiltrate their structure there, man, the way that they've been living their life. They'll look at me and be like, man, this old country bumpkin coming up here trying to infiltrate, trying to turn this cat on this cat, trying to turn little pistol popper on little popcorn up here in our state. Man, I'm going to leave you there in a body bag if it happens. So, why, when somebody from one of them other states, man, New York, California, Chicago, Louisiana, anywhere, come to Texas or come to Austin, Texas, to my home and infiltrate our structure, turn me against my homeboys I grew up with, just because I ain't seen my homeboy in 5, 6, 7, 8 years, maybe even 10. Why I'm going to turn on him because this cat right here done came from another state and made me turn on that cat? See, man, that's where accountability come in. See, a lot of us, man, have allowed infiltrators to come in here and change up our mix, change up our chemistry. Man, love on me, man. If you've been knowing me since 1970, man, you better treat me like you've been knowing me since 1970, because that's the way I treat you. Otherwise, I'm going to have to separate myself from you. I don't want to see you. You know what I mean? And when you step out of line, you need to be castrated, man, because that ain't no way to behave. Now, on to some better things, man. More peaceful, more calm. All that was just talking about us trying to keep ourselves in line, man, for us, how we treat each other, man. You know, that's respect, unity, loyalty, and education. We got to start it right here on our own home front. If we introduce the rules to the game of life into our own home front, then we can work ourselves abroad, man, and spread it out. And then everybody's always pitting against each other, man. We out here doing some of the same things, trying to help the homeless and trying to help each other, man, in the community, man, trying to save our community, trying to buy a community. We need to pull together, man, pull our resources together, man. And you don't, it don't matter who first to do it, man. Let's just all do it together. See, I don't need to be no leader, man. I don't care about being no leader. That's not my thing. Just let me sit on the board, man. Let me sit on the board that passes the laws or whatever it is that need to be passed through. You know, we got to start our community with our own people. You know what I'm saying? We got to have a mixture. Pastors, you know, priests, killers, drug dealers, whatever else, man, that's been out there, man, that we have, need to pull in our resources, man, all together. And that's functioning under one accord, under one umbrella, man. That's all I got to say, man. And I don't need to be no leader. Like I said, just sit on the board, man. Jim has spoken, man. There's more to be said. But I'm going to end it there. Man, y'all have a great day. I hope somebody's inspired. Man, somebody told me today, they called me this morning on the telephone from out of state and said, man, you need to go back, take the music out of there and just record that video. And then when you record that video, man, post it back up, man, and let it spread like an epidemic, like a disease, man. Get it out there and let it spread, because some of your own peers are the ones that need to hear it. And that, my friends, is church. One love, man. I catch you on the flip side. And remember, gems are in the hood. I'm coming to see you. Stay tuned. One love.